Before I set off, the idea was that I had to work with a photographer. And the photographer was one of the most famous food photographers internationally, Robert Fresson. And he had done a book on the food of France that was absolutely magnificent. So he came round to this house and he said, "I want to travel with you." And I said no, because I knew that photographers took a long, long time setting up. And what he needed was a place where we could spend the day doing several photos. And I had to go looking for a cheese person, a salami maker, and I had to find people who talked, because what I needed was words to put in the stories. I needed to know about the past, about the history, about the story of the villagers, what everything that anybody could tell me. But I had to talk to people, and I had to find people to talk to. And then I'd had to, you don't stay the whole day. You have your interview, I didn't call them interview, but I had my pencil and paper, and I wrote. And I couldn't do it with a photographer. And so he said, "Well, you go ahead and you find the place where I can photograph. And also, can you find me old things like old plates and old, because I don't want modern stuff." Because Italy at that time, it was after the war, they all wanted modern stuff. They wanted stainless steel in the kitchen. They wanted old baskets for making cheese. But actually, for hygiene laws, they had to, couldn't have marble. They had to have stainless steel. They had to have plastic baskets, you know, to make cheese. And he said, "And I want to photograph where there are no cars." And he said, "A bicycle, okay." But and then he said, "If you know if there's an old lady who goes there, sits there." You know, he wanted, in the end, his image he was looking for was an image of Italy long past. But so I went to antique shops to say, "Yes, they've got plates here." You know, in Tuscany, they had all these, antique shops and they had antique markets and so on. But then when I found many of the things in these antique shops came from England, because I think in Victorian times, the English had more stuff than anybody else in the world in the way of plates and knives and forks and everything, and so, and furniture as well. And so, but yes, so sometimes we got plates that came from Yugoslavia. but so, yes, it had its funny side, but people adored his photographs, and because it was of a dream Italy that really did not exist anymore. And actually, we parted ways because publishers wanted to do my book. There was an auction there again, because they as soon as the Sunday Times magazine came out, they would like to have had the words and the photographs. He wanted to buy my words because he was much more famous than I was, the photographer, and earned a lot more from doing the photographs than I did from doing the writing and the recipes, I think. Anyway, that's what the editor told me. But the publishers wanted my words and the recipes. And so we had parted ways. He was going to find somebody to write other recipes for him, which was difficult for him. It took him several years and it didn't work because, you know, it was my recipes that were the people that we saw and the photographs he took.